Hello, and welcome back to Volume. My name is Kuzon. Today we're going to continue right where we were originally with this game. We've currently discovered that we are basically a Robin Hood of sorts. And actually, I did a little bit of research on this, and it's quite fascinating to see how exactly everything works together. You see, when I was searching, you know, the last episode's name was High Tech Robin Hood, but I only discovered that this story is based on that when I was searching for thumbnail images, and I stumbled across some thumbnails that had the word Robin Hood in it, and it just made perfect sense. Stealing from the rich, giving it to the poor, taking things back from Gisborne Industries, it makes sense. But not only does it make sense in that, but the character's name, his name is Rob. Makes sense. And did you know? And so I started doing some digging. Anyway, I'll talk about the actual parallels in this story that directly correlate to the actual old Robin Hood story. And we'll talk about that in just a second. But first, let's do this next section. The banker's lawyer also has some interesting holdings. If you were to steal from her, I'd recommend doing so during their weekly squash game. This is the one that we stopped on before. That had the this interesting mechanic here. It is done. Oh, is it done now? You say. So now we're gonna go sneak around here. You don't even know about me. But yeah, so apparently this game is supposed to be borrows heavily from the old tale of Robin Hood. Obviously his name is Rob, but his last name is Luxley. Fun name. That's not just any old British name. That is the name of the town where the real Robin Hood was supposedly born. Robin of Luxley. Of the town of Luxley in Nottingham. Fun fact. And Alan was the name of one of his followers. Apparently there's a legend. The legend of Robin Hood happens. Oh, alright. Picking up the bugle. The legend of Robin Hood correlates to, sorry, hang on. I need to focus here for a second. So let me do the bugle, and then while the pawn's walking, we'll talk more about Alan. Oh, there we go. Hey. Oh, no. It's not gonna work. But that's not gonna work either. We have to do this just right. Investigating. There we go. So Alan was apparently one of Robin Hood's followers in the story. Apparently, in one of the legends, he was supposed to be married. He was getting married to this woman that he loved very much, but this bishop said, "No, you can't do that." So Robin Hood did all these shenanigans, and with the help of Friar Tuck, managed to get the two married. I don't know the exact details. I researched this like 15 minutes before I started recording the video, so I don't know too much about it, but it's really interesting, and I find it really interesting that this game, it's actually something really cool with like taking classic literature and borrowing from it. That's really one of the coolest things that you can do. It's building off of it. Look, fair use, taking an old somebody else's story and creating something new with it. Granted, there's no copyright in the story of Robin Hood. Robin Hood's been in fair use for years. For centuries, actually. Before copyright law was even a thing.
Is there someone out there? Who goes there?
Here we go. Sneaking. Sneaky, sneaky!
What was that? Investigating.
I think one of the coolest things that... And remember, this is what I remember in my senior year of high school. I read this book called How to Read Literature Like a Professor. It was part of my English course. And, you know, they were telling us about, you know, how we're always how modern works of literature are always borrowing from old works of literature, you know, old Greek tales like Persephone and Achilles and like the really, really old tales. Really old ones. And so if you know these tales, you'll be able to catch them as you read more modern works of literature. And a sign of a really good piece of literature is one that borrows from a lot of different things and builds more meaning on it. And actually you understand more about the work that you're reading or the work that you're playing or watching if you know the backstory behind it. For the fact I now know there's a very high likelihood that Alan, this AI, is probably going to become our friend, because that's what happens in the original story of Robin Hood, rather than betraying us to the corporation. So, that's where my bets are. But who knows, maybe this story tells things a little bit differently. Maybe they think that Alan's, you know, going to, you know, do something. I don't know. But Alan's got his own story going on. Sometimes I feel like Alan's the main character. Almost, which is really, really interesting. Anyways, a hidden sin. The queen's teenage son is at a university in the Midlands. His university hides expensive inherited heirlooms. Time to go shake those peoples.
Falling back.
Ooh, hide. Press space to hide in the locker when the coast is clear. Press space to exit. Okay, but there is a certain amount of time. Gotcha. Oh, oops. Hide. Man, that pawn did not do his job very well. Alright. I'm actually gonna wait until he comes back out. But yeah, I find that really, really cool. So maybe next time, maybe in the next couple of episodes of the next recording session, I'll do some research on Robin Hood in the background. Or if you guys want to do research Robin Hood on your own so you can understand the story better. That's really, really cool. And I really... Ah, now... Okay, we gotta make this much quicker. Okay, but yeah, it's really recommend that you guys go and research these things. And that's one of the cool things that you can do when you're looking up classic literature. You know, I really think that people... I know that we always said that, you know, books are boring and stuff like that, but they're really not. Like, so there are some really interesting books out there and some really interesting stories. I love stories. I don't know about you, but I love stories. Except for Citizen Kane. That story was so boring. They made us watch Citizen Kane at least like 3 times when I was at film school at the university. And man, I hated that story so much. It was so boring. It's a great work of literature, don't get me wrong, but man, is it boring. Is it boring sometimes to have to listen to that? Alright, time to... Yes, you could have sworn. You'll be swearing on your mother- Ah, no, 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 no. You don't even know! Are you serious? Oh, no, he got me. He got me. I would have just laughed. Like, the real Robin Hood would have been, are you serious? Dude, are you serious? Are you serious right now? You have brought shame on your family! Oh, whoops.
What was that?
Oh, whoops. There we go. Oh my gosh! Really?
Is that bulletproof?
Oh! They can bust you for it! Good to know. I'm just testing the program, guys! I knew that he was gonna... Okay, hang on. Let's keep this up. But yeah. What were some of your favorite books? I remember there were some really good books that I had to read for English literature, like Catch 22. That was a fun one. Oh, nope. I'm too distracted. Too distracted by Catch 22. This guy should not be this hard. Okay, just let me focus on this pawn for a second. Then we'll get back to it. Okay. I know what I need to do, but he turns around too quickly. So,
Target lost. Investigating. Returning to patrol.
Oh, he turns around, and then by default. Interesting. Yes, we did it. Oh, crud. Oh, that's what the door's for. Oh, sweet. The checkpoint. So, but we didn't know that we had to hide in there, so. I feel less bad, I guess? Okay, time to throw this bugle at a weird angle. Sneaky, sneaky. Awesome. Let me just make sure that my recording software is doing pretty good. It's doing good, folks. You should not have to worry about that stuff. Hi, how you doing? I'm gonna get shot now. I'm so sorry about that, folks. Oh, so they can see me. Gotcha. Oh, what's that text? I need to see this text. Read text. Oh, exception from my kind of guy article in Synergistic UK Magazine, May 6, 2014. What year is it? 2014? Oh, it's Belinda Ho again. He leans back, his boyish smile notching up, something approaching gravity. That's a very, very strange sentence. Very, very strange sentence. Very literature-esque. Oh, literature in your words. That's what, like, Catch-22 is all in slang. I'm proud of where I'm from. I'm proud of my country. I'm not embarrassed by that. The answer strikes me as defensive. I push. Oh, she's a reporter. But you are a man of the internet age and international. It's fun to travel. It's fun to spread your wings, but I want a home. England is one hell of a place with an incredible past, and I hope an even more incredible future. That's really... You're not answering the question. Yeah, you're really not answering the question at all, sir. You're a man of the internet age and international something. So what gives? Okay, it's very clear what I have to do here. Question, can I use the bugle while I'm inside the door? No. Okay. But yeah, my favorite novels were, I think, Catch-22 was fun. The Astonishing Life of Octavian Nothing was fun. That was an optional one that, optional one. We were told that we could read one of three books. I don't remember which ones they were, but it was the Astonishing Life, one of them was the Astonishing Life of Octavian Nothing. It was about a black child living in pre-colonial America, and he was part of a scientific organization that used him as a test subject, but like in a humane way, you know, just like teaching him literature and arts and stuff like that. He was very well educated. And then when the funding for the school, for the research organization got shut down, he had to go out into the real world, and it was a British organization, I believe, too, because again, pre-colonial America. When they got shut down, he was forced to live in the real world where he was heavily discriminated against, obviously. So, I only read part one though. I know there was a part two where he broke out of this home where he was in. I don't remember. It was so long ago. It was like 6 years ago, man. Long time ago. Okay. Oh, a new guy. Okay. The Cost of Life. The merchant's lavish home betrays his wealth. Wealth derived by selling men and women into the factories of the North. You're gonna get it! You are going to get what's coming to you, sir.
Target lost. Is there someone out there? Returning to patrol.
You are going to get it, sir. Your home might be lavish, but it's nothing.
Something over there.
Alright, what's this? To Susan Cray from Tim Shearsmith. Wow. So there's this guy. Hey, Sue, says Tim. He asked me out! Oh! I'll keep you informed. Very informed of every possible and slightly embarrassing detail. Love, Tim. Love, Tim? So they're co-workers. Oh, wait, this is 2311. Oh, right, English dates. Because it's the month, it's the day, then the month, then the year. So this is November 23rd, 2036. Interesting. So we are in the far future. So this was much, much more recent. Like 22 years more recent. Obviously, I can count numbers. I can do maths. I'm not gonna make it. Oh, I made it. Yes. Really, you think the pawns wouldn't be tricked by such simple deceptions? So simple. So simple indeed. Oh shoot! I missed one. Oh, I didn't know that I could whistle on the moor. Hi there. I'm gonna get murdered now. Goodbye. Hopefully I won't ever see you again.
Something over there.
Okay, awesome. I have the bugle. Okay, this is gonna be much harder now.
What was that?
Or is it? Okay, what else do I remember? What else do I remember was really, really fun to read? To Kill a Mockingbird was okay. I didn't personally enjoy that one. I enjoyed it more than the movie, to be honest. But, oh, what else was there? What other good books were there that I read? Macbeth I didn't like. I hated Shakespeare. In general, I just did not like Shakespeare, especially Romeo and Juliet. Well, Romeo and Juliet was a different reason. The reason for hating Romeo and Juliet was because, crap. This darn bugle, I don't like the bugle. I never liked the bugle. Oh!
I will find you.
The reason I didn't like Romeo and Juliet was because we had to do a skit. And I didn't like that project. The project was sort of fun. It was not as bad as most other projects. We had to reenact all of scene 3. I had to play Tybalt. So, I got to kill someone? Sort of. Didn't get to actually kill someone, don't worry guys. I'm not crazy.
Investigating.
But, it was interesting. It was interesting. Okay, now this.
Did I see something?
Yeah. Awesome. Okay. But yeah, it was really fun. That was fun. I don't remember what I was talking about. Anyways, distractions of the heart. now on the run, as the stream revealed his list had been stolen. A ransacked office holds the banker's final reserves. The ransackers are still there and must be avoided. Wait, what? Now on the run, as the stream revealed his list had been stolen. Oh! Let's just see what's going on here. Maybe Alan will talk to us. Help us explain a little bit more. Oh, there's more text. The oddity. Pick up the oddity with space aim, then launch that to create a distracting item that will capture attention. Oh, the oddity's still charging. Alright, text. Oddities are absolutely fascinating to enemies. Think of a thing you'd have a great time looking at. Think of something so mind-boggling fantastic that you couldn't ever be, that you couldn't even be distracted by noise. That's what an oddity is. Probably. So, boobs. Maybe. After all, like, how would you be able to simulate that in this kind of an environment? Lovely picture frames, so nicely placed. Almost like I was trying to direct your eye in some way, huh? I've been reading some turn-of-the-century game design theory books. Useful stuff! He speed reads it. Oh, okay. So it charges. Oh, whoops. Now, be concerned with the heart of hell that the pawn just went. I'm sorry, what? Oh boy, that was fun. Okay, but anyways, I think we're gonna call it good for this episode. It's only been like, what, it's been 15 minutes or so? 22 minutes? I've had some, there was some extra time on that one. But anyways, hang on a second. Oh crud, I messed it up again. I just throw it over into the corner. That's what I should be doing right now.
Shiny.
Oh, there's a timer for how long he's focused on it. Gotcha. Shiny. Oh, he's looking at it. He's looking at it. Get distracted. Get distracted. Get distracted. He's not distracted anymore. Okay. Alright, now both of you guys look at it. Is that an iPod? Is that the next gen iPod? Look at the shiny, look at the shiny, look at the shiny, look at the shiny, look at the shiny. Ooh, he didn't look at the shiny. They still do their jobs. Very important. I am sneaking, sneaking, sneaking. Like, I'm sorry. Okay. You are suddenly going to become very interested in this chair. Look at it. That's not what I wanted you to look at.
What are you?
He saw another shiny thing that caught his attention. That's me being very, very impulsive with that. Very much so. Ooh, hello, the actor. The banker. The merchant. The deposed queen, the actor. The actor is known far and wide for charitable efforts. The headquarters of her charitable interests hide a dark secret. Someone should steal evidence, Sean Connery. Someone should steal evidence that it shares only one charity, her purse. Alright guys, that's gonna call it good for this episode. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Kuzon. This is the final required episode, but you know what? I've been told that people like this series. I think I'm going to keep play it. And also, I like literature. And I like the fact that this borrows from stuff. And I'm going to keep playing this because I want to know how this ends. And I want to know how this relates to Robin Hood. So we're going to keep going. I feel smart. I feel smart when I'm talking about this. If the game makes me feel smart, I'm probably going to keep playing it. Alright, you guys have a good night, and wish you good luck.